The line in this poem that always strikes me is, though far outnumbered, let us show us brave. That's a weird way to say that, but by saying it so weirdly, it calls this great attention to it, and it's slightly different than let us be brave. You know, it's let us show us brave. Let us prove this bravery that the poem is also calling forth, but also kind of making happen. It's a little like Come Celebrate With Me, or Once You Celebrate With Me by Lucille Clifton. It's naming this thing and also by that way getting past it. There's a triumph in it, but there's also peril and danger. And I think it wouldn't be as good a poem if it was only about one or the other. If it was only about how terrible things were, or if it was only about how great things can be and that I am, I don't think it would be as powerful as what I would almost call a kind of blues notion that he's wrestling with and talking about triumph and enacting it through rhyme. You know, every time you hit that rhyme, which when you see it on the page, it can feel like it's only at the end, but reading aloud, you hear that it's throughout the poem. There's all these what are called internal rhymes within the lines. It's almost like a rap song in that way. It doesn't just rhyme at the end, it rhymes throughout. That's really interesting in a way of saying there's this continuity, there's this connection. And the we is very powerful in that way too. You see a lot of we throughout the anthology and throughout African American poetry as people are thinking about the collective and community. And here he names it in many different ways. If we must die, oh, let us nobly die. And then he says, oh, kinsmen, you know, a word you don't hear much these days. But he's thinking about the we as kin, which is a very powerful notion. It's a little different than family. You know, kin is connected and unerasable. And the other thing about If We Must Die is it's written in 1919 and published then. Red Summer, the summer of race riots, which really are more like attacks on black people. And so he's writing through an actual context that helps us understand racial violence, and what is being resisted here isn't abstract. And I think that's important today when we're thinking about violence and race and these kinds of questions and threats to body and community that are very real. And 100 years before, here we have someone writing about something that still feels very powerful and relevant.